listen while I tell you the story of a battle that happened years ago, where brave men fought and died for their people, for the waters of the Little Bighorn flow. For many years the Indian fought the white man. I guess they knew the end was growing near, but this time they would show the whites forever what it meant to be an Indian warrior. That morning General Custer came a-marching from the south with his 600 men. He planned to catch the Indians a-sleeping. He didn't know he wouldn't live to fight again. Pocahontas, it's a good day to die. Sitting Bull made medicine on the mountain while Crazy Horse got ready for the fight. Some 2,000 brave Sioux and Cheyenne prepared for their battle with the whites. Scouts for General Custer tried to warn him to wait for soldiers coming any day, but Custer didn't want to share the glory. He thought the Indians might just get away. At noon, Custer gave his final order, and there beneath the blue Montana sky, from out of nowhere came the hordes of red men. As they charged, he heard their battle cry. Pocahontas, it's a good day to die. The quiet of the day had now been shattered, the air filled with arrow smoke and lead. The bloody battle lasted just 1 hour. Custer and his soldiers all lay dead. Now the wind, it still blows across the prairie. The seasons, they come and they go, but this, the red man's day of glory, we will all remember evermore. Yes, we recall that famous day of glory. Pocahontas, it's a good day to die.